Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today we will be preparing some sodium silicate from silicon dioxide. Sodium silicate is useful for making high-temperature refractory bricks and linings for high-temperature furnaces, and it's also used in a cool experiment known as the chemical garden. To begin, we can weigh out 1,500 grams of sodium hydroxide and 2,254 grams of silicon dioxide. The sodium hydroxide can be purchased as lye or drain cleaner from hardware stores, and the silicon dioxide can be found from pottery supply stores. Alternatively, the pure silicon dioxide we prepared in a previous video could also be used if higher quality sodium silicate is desired. Beach sand could also be used if the final purity of the sodium silicate is not important. The sodium hydroxide pellets were ground into a powder, and then everything was added to a large pickle jar to shake and thoroughly mix the two powders. The powders were added to a large steel pot, and it was placed under a large propane torch to fully melt and react. To allow everything to reach a red hot temperature, it was insulated with some bricks. As the sodium hydroxide melts, it reacts with the silicon dioxide to produce sodium silicate and water. Once no more water is evolved from the reaction mixture, it can be left to cool. Once cooled, lots of water could be added to the mixture to dissolve the sodium silicate. The solution could be left to sit for a bit so that unreacted silicon dioxide settles out, and then the mixture could be decanted and filtered through a large funnel with a coffee filter shoved in the bottom to remove the remaining silicon dioxide. After filtering, the solution was added to a steel pot and boiled down to reduce the volume. It is important not to use glass, as unreacted sodium hydroxide will destroy and etch the glass. As the mixture was boiled, it was frequently tested with a steel rod to determine when the solution volume was sufficiently reduced. Once the sodium silicate solution freezes on the end of the rod like this, the solution is sufficiently concentrated for preparing refractory mixes and the heating can be stopped. Once cooled, the mixture is even more viscous. It can then be added to a large jug for storage. The solution is dark due to impurities from the pottery-grade silicon dioxide, however this is not an issue for the purposes of making refractory materials. If you're wanting to use the sodium silicate to do the chemical garden reaction, you should use the pure silicon dioxide we made in a previous video so that a nice clear solution of sodium silicate is obtained. Alternatively, the sodium silicate solution can be completely boiled down, crushed, and added to some ethanol. The impurities in unreacted sodium hydroxide will dissolve into the ethanol, leaving a sodium silicate suspension which can be filtered off to obtain pure sodium silicate. Anyhow, that is essentially how to prepare sodium silicate, also known as water glass, from silicon dioxide. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you in a future video. Okay, bye.